Darcy just mentioned, people are able to get back into the building, but a lot of them are not going to take advantage of this because they won't have electricity to tomorrow, and some of them also won't have water. A few residents, though, earlier this afternoon were able to get inside and grab a handful of their belongings. Residents of all ages, many in their pajamas and flip-flops, ran into the cold morning air trying to escape the fire and heavy smoke inside their building.
I grabbed my bag. I didn't put on a coat or anything like that, so I was standing in the cold for a while. And
some people were trapped inside their apartments. Aylin Vessel lives on the fifth floor where the explosion happened and had to stay in his bathroom until the smoke cleared out.
I was trying to leave, actually, trying to go downstairs. The whole hallway was black, so I couldn't even leave. So I just had to stay in my bathroom.
How long were you in there?
For like maybe 2 hours.
He stuffed towels under his door to keep the smoke out and started calling people on his phone, not knowing if he'd make it out.
I think about if I die here, I don't want to go out this way.
He did finally get out, and like many people from the building, took shelter in the gym at Winchester Thurston School. It's just across the street from the building.
Well, we are on spring break right now, and so it's not disrupting us at all. And I think even if it were, we'd want to do this for our neighbors.
The school even served lunch. The Red Cross and Salvation Army helped out with food and blankets. An American Eagle came by to drop off dozens of boxes of coats, shoes, and warm clothing. Some of the residents say that they will take comfort knowing that they have homeowners insurance or renters insurance to help them here in the long run. Reporting live, I'm Kelly Brennan, Channel 4 Action News.